Looks like the biggest deal in video game industry history will get done after all. A U.S. judge has given the thumbs up to Microsoft's $69 billion purchase of video game maker Activision Blizzard. The judge rejected the Biden administration's contention the agreement would hurt consumers by giving Microsoft's Xbox exclusive access to games like the best-selling Call of Duty and Diablo. Shortly after the U.S. judge's ruling, Britain's Competition and Markets Authority said it was prepared to consider Microsoft's proposal to resolve antitrust concerns in the U.K. Activision shares surged 10% following these developments. The demand for nickel has yet to recover from the pandemic, despite a global economic rebound. The Philippine Nickel Industry Association attributes this to several factors, including a weaker Chinese economy, as well as the downtrend in oil prices. The group expects demand to recover by the first half of 2024. It also sees more investment in nickel in the country in the next few years.
We're seeing more take up in the nickel space for the battery grade sector over the next 5 years, probably going to take up more than 20-30%, about 20-30%. Right now, the electric vehicle sales is up by more than 60% for the last 10 years, and we're going to see that doubling up probably just over the next 5 years.
The Philippines is the world's second largest nickel producer after Indonesia. Now, a survey finds majority of Filipinos are more concerned with rising commodity prices compared with experiencing another pandemic. According to a report by marketing data and analytics firm Kantar, 7 out of 10 Filipinos care more about grocery prices. Other concerns of respondents include climate change, potential fuel shortages, and physical and mental health. Economic outlook as well as food shortage are the least concerns of those surveyed. The survey also found Filipinos place more importance on value and convenience during inflationary times. The results are based on the answers of 2,000 households across the Philippines.
The Asia United Bank names its new chairman of the board. Jonathan Nang was elected during the bank's board of directors meeting last July 4. He will take over the chairmanship from Abraham Ko, who was elected vice chairman. Nang is the son of AUB founder and chairman emeritus Jacinto Nang Sr. He is currently the vice chairman of his family's Republic Biscuit Corporation, or Rebisco, and was a member of the bank's board of director from 1998 to 2016. AUB is one of only two local commercial banks that was granted a full branch commercial banking license in 1997 when a sweeping financial crisis grappled much of East and Southeast Asia. Double Dragons Hotel 101 picks the luxury real estate agent of top auction house Christie's as its exclusive master sales agent for its first overseas project in Japan. Double Dragon says hi to Christie's, may also tap sub-agents under it to market the Hotel 101 Niseko project, which will be located in the northern region of Hokkaido. It is expected to generate around 7 billion pesos in unit sales revenues. Once completed, it will have 482 rooms. All eyes now on the United States for the release of its crucial June inflation data. Consumer prices stateside are out later this Wednesday with a consensus that core inflation will fall further to 5%. From last month's 5.3. The Federal Reserve is expected to take cue from that on whether it will continue its aggressive tightening or keep its rates steady once more. America's Monetary Authority targets inflation this year to settle at 2%. Now, one analyst, though, expects the Fed to remain undeterred, even with a lower CPI.
So as far as the CPI and PPI report this week, you know, I think we'll see a big deceleration in headline CPI. But even if we were to come in below consensus expectations, you know, say sub 3%, if core CPI proves sticky around that 5% number, it's going to be really hard to get the Fed off their predetermined path. Basically, at this point, they are only watching the labor market and core services ex housing, which is all wage growth. Wages have proven sticky in that 4 to 5% range. The labor market has remained resilient and fairly tight. And so the Fed is not going to be swayed, in my opinion, by even if headline inflation were to print below 3%.
Here's a look at how financial markets traded today. The major indices here in Asia were mixed on investor jitters from America's upcoming CPI data. The Nikkei 225 shed 0.8% as Japan's wholesale inflation slowed for a sixth straight month to 4.1%. The Kospi, meanwhile, was up nearly 0.5%, even as South Korea's unemployment rate slightly rose to 2.6% last month. In Australia, the ASX 200 was also in the green. Investors there are digesting comments from Central Bank Governor Philip Lowe that they may further hike rates to control inflation. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They're pointing to a higher open following the positive cues from Wall Street overnight. London's FTSE 100 on the flat side as investors parse through the Bank of England's financial stability report, which came in just before the bell. The bank saying the British economy as well as banks are proving resilient despite higher interest rates. Over in the U.S., Wall Street futures are flat with caution, the name of the game. Aside from the all-import June inflation, traders are also buckling up for the second quarter earnings season, which will kick off with Wall Street banks including J.P. Morgan and Wells Fargo.
About a quarter of jobs could be lost to robots powered by artificial intelligence. That warning coming from the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, a 38-member bloc composed mostly of wealthy nations. It says 27% of jobs could easily be automated with the support of AI. The bloc also said a survey last year showed 3 out of 5 workers fear they could lose their jobs to AI over the next decade. It urged governments to help workers prepare for the transition, ensure workers' rights, and benefit from the changes that the AI revolution will spark. Amazon hopes to tempt American shoppers to open their inflation-thin wallets with big discounts on a wide range of goods and services on Prime Day. The 2-day shopping event includes Amazon's first ever travel discounts. The e-commerce giant recorded nearly $12 billion in sales during last year's Prime Day. The Bank of America projects this year's Prime Day sale will generate $12 billion in gross merchandise value. But Prime Day is facing stiff competition, with retailer Walmart also offering deals during its so-called Plus Week.
Today's numbers that matter, 64 billion pesos, that's the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation's total dividend remittances since 2011. Now, PAGCOR Chairman Alejandro Tenco reported that Tuesday during the gaming regulator's 40th anniversary. He adds PAGCOR's total contributions to nation building has now reached 607 billion pesos. President Marcos, who was present during the event, urged PAGCOR to commit to fighting illicit activities. His remarks after the recent discovery of some 2,700 foreign workers and local contacts during a sweep at the Philippine Offshore Gaming Operators Center in Las Piñas.
Now for the fans out there, shares of Blackpink's management agency drop on Wednesday amid reports the contract renewal of one of its members is in doubt. YG Entertainment traded lower by close to 6%, or at 74,000 Korean won, its lowest since May this year. That's after a local media outlet reported Lisa has not been able to reach an agreement on her contract extension with YG. Another outlet quotes YG as saying the renewal talks are underway. But Munhwa Ilbo reports the differences between the two sides is quite large. Citing an industry insider, the newspaper says the renewal process for Blackpink's other members, Jennie, Rosé, and Jisoo, are proceeding smoothly.